Yeah, hello. Good evening, all. Okay, let's see. Today's topic is about blood and lymphatic system. Okay. Are you able to see the slides?
Yes, ma'am.
So, coming to the blood. So, blood is the major transport medium in our body. It transports the substances throughout the body. What are the substances? Either it may be the useful substance or unwanted waste products. So, majorly, it has two contents. One is cells and other one is liquid part. So, the cellular part, we call it as RBC, WBC and platelets. And the liquid part is the plasma. So, first one is the red blood cells will carry the oxygen. The WBC will fight against the infections and diseases, and platelets will usually help for the blood to clot. And coming to the components, as we already seen, blood we have erythrocytes, platelets and leukocytes. Leukocytes means white blood cells. And we have the plasma. So this is the picture of the blood. So through phlebotomy means puncturing the vein. So through phlebotomy, the blood is withdrawn from the hand and it is collected in the test tube as a specimen. And through separate the components, we will put in the centrifugation machine. So this is centrifuge. So in this centrifuge, by rotating, it will separate the contents. So by after separating the contents, you can able to see here. This yellow color fluid, we call it as the plasma. And here, this whitish color part, we have the platelets and WBC. And this entire major red color part occupies by the RBC. And coming to the combining forms, agglutino. Agglutino means clumping. So when you mix the A blood group with the B blood group, so the clumping will take place. So that we call it as clumping. So agglutination is different from clotting. Clotting is usually whenever the blood was leaked or when we take the blood sample out of the body, the blood will clot immediately. That we call it as converting the liquid form of the blood into solid. But agglutination is mismatched blood. So group A with group B or group A with group AB, likewise. Baso means base. Chromo, which means color. Coagulo, which means clotting. Isino means rosy red. Erythro, which means red. Fibrino means fibers or fibrous. Granulo, which means granules. So if the presence of granules, we call it as granulocytes. And the absence of granules, we call it as agranulocytes. And next, hemo. Hemo means blood. Hemo, hemato, both means blood. Leuko means white. And morpho means shape. So morphology means study of shape. Neutro, which means neutral. And phago means eat or swallow. Sanguino is blood. So likewise, hemo, hemato, sanguino is also blood. And thrombo means blood clot. So thrombocytes means the cells for blood clot. So platelets, we call it as thrombocytes. And coming to the blood suffixes, apheresis. Apheresis means removal. So for example, plasmapheresis, removal of the plasma. Cytosis, more than normal number of cells, we call it as cytosis. For example, erythrocytosis, more than normal number of RBC. And leukocytosis, more than normal number of WBC. And thrombocytosis, more than normal number of platelets. Emia, any related blood condition, we call it as emia. For example, uremia, means increase of nitrogenous waste products in the blood, we call it as uremia. And next, globin. Globin means protein. So hemoglobin. So heme means iron, globin is protein. Penia. Penia means abnormal decrease of the count, which is quite opposite with the cytosis. So, for example, erythropenia, leukopenia, thrombopenia. So, leukopenia, we also call it as blood cancer. Phil means attraction. Poiesis means formation or production. Stasis, which means standing still. Coming to the anatomy and physiology part, on an average adult, we have around 5 liters of blood, which circulates throughout the body within the blood vessels. Blood cells are produced in the red bone marrow. We call that process as hematopoiesis. So coming to the anatomy and physiology again. So the blood is actually the mixture of cells floating in the fluid called plasma. And the cells are erythrocytes, leukocytes, platelets. And coming to the plasma, this after taking the sample, this yellow color part, we call it as plasma. So there are around 55% of the whole blood. The plasma will occupy 90 to 92% is water only. And 8 to 10% will be dissolved substances such as glucose, amino acids, triglycerides, and urea, ammonia, likewise carbon dioxide, oxygen, sodium, potassium, calcium, magnesium, all this stuff. And coming to the dissolved things, we have the plasma proteins in the plasma. We have three important plasma proteins, that is albumin, globulin, and fibrinogen. Albumin is for helps for the transportation of fatty substances. Globulin, we have, for example, gamma globulins. These are actually the antibodies. And fibrinogen. So we have the gamma globulins like GAMED, GAMED, we call it as IgG, IgA, IgM, IgE, and IgD. These are gamma globulins, which are plasma proteins. And fibrinogen. So for blood clotting, this is the very important protein. And we have blood clotting cell, we call it as thrombocytes. To hold the thrombocytes, we have the protein called fibrinogen. And additional substances are calcium, potassium, sodium, glucose, amino acids, fats, urea, and creatinine. And next we have the sample. In this sample, again, as usual, we have seen previously, this yellowish part is the plasma. And this whitish part, we have the eosinophils, basophils, lymphocytes and monocytes and neutrophils. These five things we call it as WBC or leukocytes or white blood cells. And here we have the platelets. And this is RBC. RBC is actually discoid in shape, which is biconcave. Biconcave, discoid, and it is red in color because of the pigment called hemoglobin. And first one is RBC. RBC, we also call it as erythrocytes, which is enucleated. Enucleated means no nucleus. So because to occupy or to carry more amount of oxygen, the nucleus will dissolve or disintegrate. We have around 5 million per cubic millimeter of the blood. This is the normal RBC count. And for an adult, assume we will have around 35 trillion more in milk. And first one is erythrocytes. So in the erythrocytes, we have a pigment called hemoglobin, which gives the blood red color. So because of the iron, heme, we call it as iron, and which is responsible for the transport of oxygen. And the lifespan of RBC is 120 days. The spleen will usually remove the RBC. That's why we call the spleen as graveyard of RBC, because the RBC will die in the spleen. And iron is reused again. And finally, we will have the bilirubin as the waste product that will be disposed by the liver. And from the bilirubin will go out through the urine and the fecal matter. Because of that, only our urine and fecal matter are yellowish in color, which is a byproduct of RBC, death of RBC. And next, WBC, we also call it as leukocytes, which is actually the spherical in shape, which is around 8,000 per cubic millimeter of the blood. This is the normal count of WBC. When we have any infections, the WBC count will increase. Coming to the next, leukocytes. Leukocytes will fight against the pathogens. So against the virus, bacteria, and foreign materials. We divide the leukocytes into two types, agranulocytes and granulocytes. Agranulocytes means in the cells, inside the cells, there will be no granules. Granulocytes means they will have granules in the cytoplasm. Coming to the next thing, leukocyte classification. We have the granulocyte and agranulocytes. Basophil, eosinophil, neutrophil. Base, acid, neutral. So that cells got attracted to that type of substance. So basophils are attracted to base. Acidophils are attracted to acids. Neutrophils are attracted to neutral substance. So actually basophils will release the histamine and also the heparin. So which was released at the damaged tissue, or any cut or any wound. The basophils will be released there. Eosinophils are during allergic infections and also due to destroy the parasites. Neutrophils will actually will increase during phagocytosis if any bacteria or virus entered into our body. And coming to the agranulocytes, we have the monocytes and lymphocytes. This plays a very key role in the immunity by phagocytosis. Phagocytosis means eating the bacteria or eating the virus or eating the pathogens. And platelets. So the older term is we call it as thrombocytes, because thrombus means blood clot, cyte means cell. So which is the smallest of all blood elements. The platelet-like fragments, so they are like plate-like fragments. So because of the larger cells, we have around 2 lakhs to 3 lakhs per cubic millimeter of blood. And you just remind the count. We have 5 millions of RBC, 8,000 of WBC, 2 lakhs to 3 lakhs of platelets. So this count should not be increased or should not be decreased. And next, which is very critical. Platelets are very critical in blood clotting. It always, blood clotting, we call it as hemostasis. Homeostasis is different from hemostasis. Homeostasis means to maintain the stable internal environment. Hemostasis means blood clotting. And we call that blood clotting as agglutination. So small clusters of blood will be there. And it leads to product formation of thrombin. The thrombin will actually convert the fibrinogen to the fibrin, which actually forms the mesh-like blood clot. And in that mesh, the thrombocytes will get captured. And that will prevent the blood to flow. I mean, it will block the hemorrhage or it will block any discharges. And coming to the blood typing, so which is major proteins are present in the RBC and in the plasma. So we have 2 types of blood grouping system. One is ABO blood grouping system and RH blood grouping system. Actually, we are combining the both blood grouping systems and we are telling the group. For example, my blood group is A positive. So I am in ABO blood grouping system, I am A. In RH blood grouping system, I am RH positive. I am combining the both the groups and I am telling it. And one more thing, it is very important to know the blood group before blood transfusion. Each and everyone, it is very important to know their own blood group. So whenever it is need for transfusion, so we can donate the blood whenever it is needed. I'll tell you easily what is actually the blood grouping is. So coming to the ABO blood grouping system, we have 4 different types. One is type A, other one is type B, and type AB and type O. So the blood grouping naming system is actually based on the antigen on the RBC. So if the antigen is A on the RBC, then the type will be A. If the antigen is B on the RBC, then the type is B. If the antigen is A and B, then the type is AB. If there are no any antigens on the RBC, then the blood group is O. So the opposite will be there on the plasma. So if the blood group is A, then in the plasma, we will have B antibodies. If the blood group is B, then the plasma will carry A antibodies. And if the blood group is A and B, the plasma doesn't have any antibodies. If the blood group is O, the plasma will be having both the antibodies. The contrast will be there. So likewise, the blood grouping system, we should not transfer the A blood group to B, B to AB. So, but in this whole blood groups, so type O, we call it as universal donor because it doesn't have any antigens. So it can give blood to any other types. And next, coming to the other. And the AB, we call it as universal recipient. It can receive blood from any other groups because it doesn't have any antibodies in the plasma. And the same thing. In an extreme emergency only, they'll go with the type O as a universal donor. and type AB as the universal recipient, not in all the cases. And Rh factor. So Rh factor means if the Rh antigen is present on the RBC, then the person is Rh positive. If the Rh antigen is absent on the RBC, then the person is Rh negative. So based on that, I am having Rh antigen, so I am Rh positive. Some other may have doesn't have Rh antigens, then they are Rh negative. So if we are combining the both ABO blood grouping system and Rh blood grouping system together, and we are telling the blood group, Rh means rhesus monkey. So, okay, it was first discovered in that monkey, so that's why they named it as Rh. So coming to the word building part, fibrinogen. Gen means production, fibrin means fibers, so fiber producing. Fibrinolysis, which means fiber destruction. Fibrinous, related or pertaining to the fibers. Hemoglobin, blood protein. Hemolysis, blood destruction. Hemolytic, which is medicine or any bacteria, if it destructs the blood, we call it as hemolytic. Hemorrhage, rapid bleeding, we call it as hemorrhage. Hematologist, the blood specialist. So hematologist is the one who studies the entire thing about the blood. Hematic, pertaining to the blood or related to the blood. Sanguineous, pertaining to the blood. Erythrocyte, erythro means red, cyte means cell. So erythrocyte, red cell. Leukocyte, white cell. Thrombocyte, clotting cell, because thrombus means blood clot. And granulocyte, which is granular cell. A granulocyte means not a granular cell. And erythrocytosis, too many RBC. Leukocytosis, too many WBC. Thrombocytosis, too many clotting cells. Erythropenia, too few red cells. Leukopenia, too few white cells. Thrombopenia, too few clotting cells. It is quite opposite to cytosis. And pancytopenia, so decrease of all the blood cells. So all the three. And erythropoiesis, production of RBC. Leukopoiesis, production of WBC. Thrombopoiesis, production of the clotting cells. Hematopoiesis, finally, production of all the blood cells. So coming to the blood vocabulary, blood clot. What actually the blood clot is? So the hard collection of fibrin and blood cells and tissue debris. All together we call it as blood clot. So which results in hemostasis, not homeostasis. Homeostasis is different from hemostasis. Coagulation. So the conversion of liquid form of blood into solid form, as we see in blood clotting. And dyscrasia. Dyscrasia means any disease that affecting the blood. We call it as dyscrasia. Hematology, which is a branch of medicine particularly specializing in diagnosis and treatment of blood-related conditions like hemocytosis, hemopenia, pancytopenia, all these blood-related conditions, any blood cancer or clotting disorders like hemophilia. All these related things comes under hematology. And the physician, we call him as hematologist. This is actually the electron micrograph picture of blood clot. You can see here, this is actually the fibrin fibers and these are the blood cells trapped. This is the picture of blood clot. And hematoma. Hematoma is actually the collection of blood under the skin. If we hit any chair or any cot when we are going, suddenly we will have a blood clot under our skin, that blackened area. We call that as hematoma. So that is because of bruising. We also call that as bruising. Hemostasis means blood clot to stop the bleeding or the stagnation of blood which flows through the tissues. Packed cell, transfusion of only blood cells without plasma. That we call it as packed cells. For example, plasmapheresis means so transfusion of only plasma without the cells. Whole blood means transfusing of both the blood cells and plasma, whole blood transfusion takes place in whole blood. And hemophilia, which is a genetic condition, the blood fails to clot. When the person will be bleeding continuously for 10 minutes, he may get hypovolemic shock or hypovolemic heart attack. And hyperlipidemia, which is very common in cholesterol. So if the person is having more amount of cholesterol in the blood, he may have excessive amount of lipids. So that, which is one of the risk factor of atherosclerosis, means clotting of the blood vessel. And septicemia, having bacteria or toxins in the bloodstream, which leads to blood poisoning. We call it as septicemia. And anemia, any condition which leads to decrease in the hemoglobin level. So we have many conditions, for example, hemolytic anemia, pernicious anemia because of the deficiency of vitamin B12, and microcytic anemia because of the deficiency of iron, and many different types of anemia is there. Because of thalassemia also we get anemia, sickle cell anemia. All these things will lead to decrease in the hemoglobin content in the blood, which leads to less oxygen carrying capacity. So less oxygen will reach through the tissues. Finally, it leads to cyanosis, clubbing, all those stuff. And next, aplastic anemia, which is the severe anemia, because the root cause is the red bone marrow stops to make the sufficient amount of blood cells, because all the blood cells will be prepared in the red bone marrow only. So these persons may require bone marrow transplantation. And hemolytic anemia will result in excessive loss of RBC. And hemolytic reaction, destruction of RBC when the patient receives the mismatched blood. Sometimes the patient wrongly will receive A blood group, will receive B group, all the stuff will happen. And hypochromic anemia. Hypochromic anemia results in insufficient amount of hemoglobin because of destruction of RBC, same like anemia. So this is because of destruction of RBC. If there are no enough number of RBC, there is no enough amount of hemoglobin, then thus leads to decrease in the oxygen carrying capacity. Iron deficiency anemia, we also call it as microcytic anemia. This results in insufficient amount of iron because iron is very essential for the preparation of hemoglobin in RBC. And pernicious anemia, this anemia is because of vitamin B12. So this is also, vitamin B12 is very essential to make the RBC. If the vitamin B12 is not sufficient, then the RBC count will get decreases. If the RBC count get decreases, the amount of hemoglobin also decreases. That leads to anemia. Polycythemia means too many of RBC. So the blood will become very thick. They may have heart diseases or stroke, CVA. Cardiovascular accident is very common for this polycythemia. And next, sickle cell anemia, which is also a genetic disorder, which comes from our fathers and forefathers. So the RBC will take an abnormal shape. The RBC shape is actually discoid. So here the RBC shape is not oval. Then the RBC shape will be changed. That leads to easy destruction of RBC. This leads to hemolytic anemia. And thalassemia, this is also one of the very important genetic disorder. They will be unable to produce the functioning hemoglobin. The hemoglobin will be there, but that is actually not a good hemoglobin to carry the oxygen. So this is the difference about, this is the normal RBC. And this is sickle cell RBC. So the sickle cell RBC lifespan will be very, very, very small, around 10 to 15 days. And coming to the leukocyte pathology, leukemia, we also call it as cancer, WBC cancer. So the WBC cells forming portion of the red bone marrow will get cancer. This leads to production of large abnormal and immature WBC circulating in the bloodstream. Coming to the clinical laboratory test, blood culture and sensitivity. So if we have any infection or if we have any disease, so we will take the blood and we will culture it and we will see the type of bacteria. Based on the type of bacteria, they will prescribe the related antibiotics. Okay. And next, complete blood count. The complete blood count is they will count the RBC, they'll count the WBC, they'll count the hemoglobin, hematocrite, white blood cell differential, means number of leukocytes, number of eosinophils, basophils, neutrophils, monocytes and lymphocytes. They'll count everything. That is complete blood count. Erythrocyte sedimentation rate. This is actually, they will take the sample to the test tube. And in the test tube, what they will do is, they will see at what rate, at what speed the RBC is settling to the bottom. Then they will see if the RBC settling rate, based on that, they will determine whether the person is having any inflammation or not. And coming to the next thing, hematocrite, so which is actually measures the volume of RBC. This is usually done for thalassemia, sickle cell anemia. Hemoglobin measures the amount of hemoglobin in the person. Platelet count, they will determine the number of platelets. This is usually done for the malaria and dengue people, and recently for COVID-19 also. And prothrombin, also called as protein, measures the how long the blood takes time to clot. So this is to see when the person is having the hemophilia or not. RBC count, they will measure the number of RBC. RBC cell morphology, this is to see the sickle cell anemia. They will see the shape of the RBC. And sequential multiple analyzer computer, which is a machine, actually will take all the chemistry test automatically with the help of computer, which is not done manually. We'll take the help of the computer. WBC count measures the number of leukocytes. And WBT differential is, it counts the number of WBC, like number of leukocytes, number of eosinophils, basophils, neutrophils, monocytes, and lymphocytes. Bone marrow aspiration. So this is done for aplastic anemia. If the person is having any bone marrow cancer or aplastic anemia, they will take the sample of bone marrow and they will check whether the person is having that cancer or not. Phlebotomy. To take the blood or to withdraw the blood, they will put an incision to withdraw the blood. We also call it as venipuncture or phlebotomy. So this is actually the picture of phlebotomy. So usually if we want to give the blood sample, they will do this. This we call it as phlebotomy. The phlebotomy was done to the vein because we can't puncture the artery. Artery will be very deeper. The vein will be superficial. So they usually puncture the vein. And autologous transfusion, collection of and storage of the patient's blood prior to the actual need. For example, if the patient was undergoing a surgery within 1 month or 2 months, they will collect the person's blood and they will store it. Whenever they need it during the surgery, they use the same person's blood. Blood transfusion, which is artificial transfer of blood into the bloodstream. We call that as blood transfusion. Bone marrow transplantation. If the person is having leukemia or aplastic anemia, the patient will receive the red bone marrow from the donor. Actually, the person's own bone marrow will get destroyed, and that bone marrow will be replaced by some other person's bone marrow. Homologous transfusion, replacement blood with person from another person. So we are taking the blood from another person. Plasmapheresis, they will collect the whole blood and they will separate the cells and they will separate the plasma. They will take the plasma alone and they will inject to the person who need the antibodies. This is recently done during COVID time. Many patients got plasmapheresis, so to take the antibodies into the body. So coming to the pharmacology, anticoagulant, so which will prevent the blood clot formation. If we don't want any blood clot, then we give anticoagulant. Antihemorrhagic, which prevents the bleeding. Antiplatelet agent, so which interferes with the action of platelets. Hematinic, increases the number of RBC and hemoglobin. And thrombolytic, which dissolves the existing blood clot. Coming to the abbreviations, ALL, acute lymphocytic leukemia, so which is a blood cancer. Acute myelogenous leukemia, this is also one more type of blood cancer. Basophil, BMT, bone marrow transplant. CBC, complete blood count. CLL, chronic lymphocytic leukemia. And CML, chronic myelogenous leukemia. This is also blood cancer. So this is the blood cancer for a long period. So this is recent when the person got the blood cancer tumor within 3 months. DIF means differential. Eosinophils means eosinophils. ESR, erythrocyte sedimentation rate. HCT, hematocrit. They'll measure the volume of RBC. And HGB means hemoglobin. Lymphs means lymphocytes. Monas means monocytes. PA, pernicious anemia. PCV, packed cell volume. PMN, polymorphonuclear neutrophil. Protime means prothrombin time, to check the time to take the blood clot, so amount of the time to blood to clot. RBC, red blood cell. Rh positive, Rh negative. Sex means segmented neutrophil. SMAC means sequential multiple analyzer computer. WBC is white blood cells. Okay, so any doubts regarding this? Regarding the topic of the blood, are you having any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Are you clear with the cellular part, plasma, all this terminology?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, could you please disconnect? Anyways, it will disconnect in 2 minutes. We'll reconnect and we'll complete with the topic of lymphatic system also. Are you fine with that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
All of you?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. If you're very clear with the blood topic, we'll go with the lymphatic topic. Okay. Okay then. Just I'll share you the link. Just connect. Okay, thank you.